time to get the Bowdon perspective of things. And coach, you know, I've been talking to other coaches around here at the event, and when we all fill out our brackets, there's always that Bowdon that is there that a lot of folks project to make deep runs in the playoffs. And to get back there in 2021, as it has been in the past, what do you think you need to do?
Well, first of all, we are fortunate to be in a tradition-rich place. The expectations are definitely high, not just with brackets, but with the people in the community. For us, number one was having a summer, not a COVID summer like we had last summer. We actually had an off-season this year. That was our number one thing. We like to pride ourselves at Bowdon that we outwork people in the off-season, and we didn't have that last year, so we felt like we came in even with everybody. So we're ahead right now. The second thing that we've got to do is we've got to be so much further ahead when game one comes than where we were a year ago. You know, we weren't ready to play football, and we had an 0-3 start and then kind of rebounded and ended up in game 12. So off season's very important. We set some goals, and our goals were to repeat as the region champions and to find a way to not only get to game 12 like we have the last 2 years, but get over that hump and be in game 13. So hopefully we're going to do the things that we need to do practice-wise. You can't just say it, and that's what we tell our kids at the end of every practice. Saying it's one thing, but going out there and playing fast, learning your read keys, you know, executing on offense and doing all those little bitty things the best you can do them is what's going to get us there.
You mentioned the community, and I want to get into that a little bit, because not everyone has been to a game at Bowdon to see what it means, to see all of that black and red on a home Friday night. For someone who's never been, break it down for them and let folks know what football means to the folks that wear the same kind of golf shirts that you do.
Well, number one, it's a place that reminds me of football back in the 70s and 80s when I was a small kid. On Friday night, there's a town square, there's a main street, and it's shut down. I mean, that stadium's going to be packed, and everybody's going to be there. Expectations are always high. I think the tradition there, I think there's 18 region titles in the history of the school, 2 state championships. So it means a lot. Every parent, every community member, every person that's in that community knows the name of every kid that wears a football jersey on Friday night. They know the names of all the coaches that wear a polo and a B as well. But it's special. All the elementary school kids know the older kids. They're all at the games. It's truly a special feeling on Friday night when you know that you're not just playing for just your school, but the entire community is there, and they expect you to put the best product that you can put on the field. You know, I told our kids the other day, it's much more fun to play where the expectations are really, really high for you as an individual and as a team than to play at a place where the expectations are not there and nobody cares what you do on Friday night. So I'm truly blessed, and it makes football really, really fun. Not to mention there's no track at that stadium, so those bleachers are right up on you on Friday night. So it's very, very loud and deafening on a Friday night.
When you look at your schedule here in 2021, break it down for me. I know that you want to challenge yourself in your non-region schedule so you can be ready by region time to get you ready to get toward Game 12 and Game 13 and so on. But break down your schedule for me, and what do you see?
Well, our first 3 games are all AA opponents. They were all top 10 opponents last year. Harrelson County actually beat the Callaway Cavaliers, who won the state title. So we feel like our first 3 games, you know, we'll see an Athletic Temple team right off the bat who was in every game with everybody in 5AA last year. You know, it all came down to the end. Anybody could have won that region. We turn around and play Bremen, not just a rival game, but they're playing as good a football as they've played in that program, probably in the history of that program. Harrelson County is playing as good a football, arguably one of the best players in the area, and Clay Hyatt. So really good, well-coached football out the gate. And like I said earlier, we were 0-3 in that stint last year. However, those 3 games prepared us for Class A and our region opponents, which is why we play them. Then we've got 2 private schools in that non-region schedule, Heritage out of Noonan and North Cobb Christian, who's been a top 10 team the last 2 years. So, you know, your goal in those games is you play them because you feel like the talent is better than what you're going to see until you get to game 12 or 13 to get you prepared for region. Last year we were 1-4 in those games. We hope to be better than that this year. And of course, if you come out of that thing 4-1 or 5-0, you feel like you're going to have a really good year. But those games are to battle test you for your region play.